Let's get some more insight and analysis now on the situation in Syria and talk to the director of the Beirut-based Centre for Middle East Studies, Dr. Hisham Jebbar. Thanks for being on the line with us, Doctor. Appreciate it. Good to see you tonight. Arab League observers are supposed to be confirming, aren't they, that Damascus is sticking to a peace deal that was brokered by the League. Do you think they will be able to do that, and how long could it take for them to confirm it?
Yeah, we cannot deny that it's a very complicated mission and a very sensitive mission. Of course, Syria did accept this protocol and did sign it because Syria want to get out, you know, from this dead end. And many observers believe that Russia was behind this and to convince Syria to accept the protocol, and which represent a breakthrough of the situation in Syria, which has been in dead end for 10 months. Now the observers, the Arab observers, came to Syria. They are not supposed to listen to political opinions. It's not their mission. They have to go and to see the facts on the land. No one can deny that there are insurgents in Syria. Now I heard the report that they say 27 civilians or insurgents. Many mass media or observers, they mixed between civilian and insurgent, because when they talk about thousands of people killed in Syria, they don't mention the insurgent. They say civilians. And also, we cannot deny that about 2,000 soldiers or security men also were killed in Syria within this period. Those observers are going to Syria to see on the land what's going on. Really, the Syrian authority and the Syrian government will give all facilities to accomplish their mission. But we have to be careful, because the Syrians did warn them that if they want to go to an area where there is fighting for their own security, they have to be in direct and permanent contact with the Syrian authority to be advised or to be protected or not. We cannot say now if they succeed or they will fail. We have to wait and to see, because this mission is very, as we said, very sensitive.
Exactly. But what is your prognosis? What do you think the implications would be if the Arab League decides that Damascus isn't keeping to its part of the deal? What would happen then?
Would you please repeat the question, because I didn't see if the Arab League want from this.
Yes.
I think those are observers only. They are not keeping.
No, they will not have
a mission.
What if they decide, Doctor, what if they decide that Damascus isn't keeping to its part of this deal? What if they find that Damascus is continuing the violence? What then?
Damascus and the government, Syrian government, I believe that, as I have a direct daily contact with Damascus and with Syria, and we do understand that Syria made it clear that is not using forces and weapons against a peaceful civilian, and is not willing to do it. But Damascus will continue to defend, you know, the official institution against the insurgent. No one can deny the presence of the insurgent in Syria. Even Hillary Clinton did recognize this and said they are well equipped and well trained, etc., etc. Now the situation, we have to be clear about defending against insurgent, and which is very, very dangerous and very sensitive. I don't think the observers can be in a situation to go on the battlefield and to see what's going on, but they have to do and to do their mission and to accomplish their mission and to do their job. But it's, as I said, Syria, the government of Syria will not continue. I am sure about it, will not shoot civilians and demonstrators, but the army in Syria will defend, will continue the military operation against deserters from the army and against the insurgent who has, you know, the most sophisticated weapons now.
Okay, well, we get your message loud and clear. If any civilians are listening tonight, hopefully they'll sleep a bit safer after hearing what you've said there. Live from Beirut, Dr. Hisham Jaber, Director of the Center for Middle East Studies. Thank you for your thoughts.